The era of The Sims 3 gave us a variety of massive open worlds for us to play in, all of which were packed with families, houses, and lore. Many Sims have their own backstory, pre-existing interpersonal relationships, and hopes for the future of their life. But with all this attention given to The Sims themselves, how do the builds stack up? What's up guys, Rakowski here, and today we'll be rating all of the builds in The Sims 3 Sunset Valley. If you enjoy hating on EA builds or want to see some nice mansions for a change, then please hit that subscribe button. Please subscribe. Thank you so much. A quick disclaimer before we begin. This video is for entertainment purposes only. This is my own judgmental opinion, and I mean no disrespect to the developers personally. If anything, I wish we had the people who made this game back in the driver's seat. Anyhow, with that out of the way, let's jump into the video. Well, here we are in Sunset Valley, and we're getting ready to start our little rating system. To judge each of these builds, I'm going to be using a combination of originality, aesthetics, functionality, and just, you know, the overall feel of the build. And I'll be ranking each build out of 10. And at the end, we'll see which builds are the best and which ones are the most questionable. To keep everything organized, we're actually going to be doing each build in alphabetical order. Don't worry, it's not the alphabet build challenge. First up is a Silmar owned by the single mom's household. Honestly, it's looking a little weird, but I think I kind of like the color scheme. I really like that red, that yellow, that blue. The creative style really gives us the ability to kind of pick any colors we want, so I won't be accepting very many excuses for like bad color combinations. The windows are a little strange. There's not really anything at the back. The front has a bunch of windows though, including a lot of small ones up at the top here. Are these just large ceilings? Oh, they are. It's only one story. Very, very primary. Where is the Comic Sans, I wonder? The layout is actually pretty nice. One thing I cannot stand is this bathroom, though. I could see this thing from space. It's hideous. Absolutely hideous. But overall, I think the layout of this house is fantastic. It's for four people in this household. We have, I think, two single moms and two daughters of different ages. We have enough space for everybody. We have seating. We have dining. We have kitchen. We have two bathrooms. We have we don't have a bedroom for everyone. We do have a toddler crib here. So it would be a little bit better if we had a toddler's bedroom. But you could probably renovate, I think, this section into a small one. It shouldn't be too big of a problem. There's enough space. And the roof, like, you can't have roofing like this in real life, because then you have like all the rain kind of gets into one place, unless it's also sloped down on the side here. But yeah, just like a little weird modern, you know, kind of typical EA build, I should say, in the earlier Sims games. I think we're gonna give a Silmar a 6. It's not awful, it works, it just has a few problems and, you know, could use a little bit of improvement. Next up is August Moon, where Agnes Crumplebottom lives. We all know who Agnes Crumplebottom is. Now, in this game, she's actually quite young because The Sims 3 is set very early in the timeline. It's the earliest of all of the main series Sims games. So her story is that she just got married, but her husband died, and his grave is over here on the lot. And I don't know too much about the houses in this world, but I do know a little bit about this one. If we zoom in to this room, I have goosebumps just thinking of this. See how it's kind of like a nursery? There's a crib, and like the wooden floor is half carpeted, and like the walls aren't quite done. It's because she was hoping to have a baby, and then her husband died, so she didn't get to have her baby. Like the wallpaper, I like these chairs like this. This is very, it's very, very ritzy. I can't be bothered to sit with you, even though you're my guest. Love it. I love this kitchen too. This is beautiful. A marble bathroom. Love it. And yeah, the upstairs is pretty nice too, you know, other than the unfinished nursery. But the downside to this house, look at this wall here. See how ugly that is? Wait. If you ever saw that video where like Plumbella had her 6-year-old niece or something try to build a house, this is the kind of house you get. Okay, the back is a little bit nicer. Don't like these windows. Don't mind the modern ones. This side on the, I don't know. There's a lot of problems. I kind of like this balcony area. I think that's about it. I like how the floor to ceiling windows go up two stories over here. Oh, there's a nice, there's not a balcony there. There's just like a fence to nothing. If we were just doing the exterior, I'd probably give this house like a 1 or 2 out of 10, but inside is really nice. And we do have that, you know, the lower child bedroom. So I have to give August Moon, the Crumplebottom residence, an 8. Because I can be as judgy as I want, but at the end of the day, like, I have played in this house. I will play in this house again, gladly. With a lot of Sims, I'm just dying to play them, and I just bulldoze the house and start over because I can't stand it. And for her, you know, I can overlook the exterior because we do spend most of our gameplay in the house. So yeah, 8 out of 10. So next up is the Cosmopolitan Lofts, and this is home to the Roomies household. As we can see, it's kind of styled more like apartments, and I don't mind that. This is before, obviously, the Nightlife expansion, because this is from the base game. So we didn't have apartments yet, but they did a pretty good job, I think, in kind of recreating that kind of floor plan and style. I like this garage. I do, because I like little realistic touches, and that's what an apartment garage would look like. I like kind of the front door area here. Again, I think that's realistic and not something a Sims builder would necessarily do. They've got some nice little balconies going on. I like it. I like this vibe. I could play in this. One thing I will note is that nothing in this house really stands out, and the inside is a little kind of blandly decorated. But I think with a place like this, it gives you a lot of room for a kind of expansion or just to put your own taste into it. So I think it's fine. I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. Next up is Cottage Cheese, and this is owned by Erin Kennedy. So before we get started on this one, I'm just going to note that she can't stand art and she's a technophobe. So if there's no TV or computer and there's no paintings, then that's because of her and not because of the build. The roof is, I mean, for Sims 3, it's all right. I'll give it that. Again, I kind of like the colors. Like the red, yellow, blue thing is a theme in Sunset Valley. And again, we have a yellowish tone to the inside. There's even yellow in this blue kitchen. It makes its way everywhere. I think this little dining room, little hutch area, I think that's very cute. I really like that. That's a really nice touch. There's a smoke alarm in the living room. Oh, and in the kitchen, I see. Oh, there's a fireplace. See, I wouldn't have even thought of that. I think that's nice. But you know, it's just a simple one bedroom, one bathroom, perhaps a few too many windows and a few too many color choices. I think it's just like a nice basic house, basic kind of starter house. I'm gonna give Cottage Cheese, I think, just a 6 out of 10. Nothing special. And this top part gives me Strangerville vibes. Next up is Flava Flu, and this is owned by the Alvi household. The dad has a unibrow. Iqbal has a unibrow. I can already see it. Unfortunately, maybe not the coolest house. I know it's supposed to be like a lower income kind of house, and I built a lot of these houses too, so I'm gonna be a little extra harsh on this one. I do like the shed with the mismatched chairs. That's a really nice touch because poor people wouldn't necessarily have a matching set. And there's just like appliances and stuff sitting around. There's a clock outside. Oh my god. At first glance, I hated this thing more, but the more I investigate, the more I like it. I like these bricks kind of being like the foundation, but it's not a complete foundation because a trailer wouldn't have that. Love the fence. I think the fence is perfect. Why don't we have a fence like this in The Sims 4? Oh, yellow. What is with yellow? I think, if there was less yellow in this game, I would be a lot happier. But I think the whole point of this house is to be like, you know, for lower income people and who are trying to make ends meet by maybe collecting some appliances and selling them and improvising their dining room set. I'm gonna give this house an 8. Is that the gate? That's the gate to the back? Oh my god, like little Simsy would die. I'm gonna give it an 8.5 out of 10. For our next house, we have the Garden Cottage. First off, love the landscaping, love the gardening. I haven't even been building so much, so I didn't even notice there wasn't that much landscaping on the other houses. I like the two-door style roof. I like that they were actually able to use posts in this game because it's very hard. They don't go on the corners of the fences. Don't love this bay window, but I think a real house would have it. There's a purple door, purple barbecue. I think there's a hint of purple in the siding, and then the purple mailbox, so I guess it's cohesive. Oh my god, the minty kitchen, I'm down for. Even the garbage can matches. Okay, oh, and the tile too. The bathroom looks like every Sims bathroom. Your toilet paper should not be that far away. Although he doesn't seem particularly creative. I thought he would be because he had an easel. That may be a bit of an oversight. Using different floor tiles in the middle to create something different like this. Now, I may have done it to a little bit more of an extreme, but I really like how they did it here. I think it adds a really nice touch to the house. And it's kind of hard to pick things that will look nice kind of from afar, like when you're playing a Sims game, and will look nice when you're like right down deep inside the house like this. I think it's just very pretty. We're gonna give this one a 7 out of 10. I really do like the landscaping. That bumped it up a notch. So next up, we have a staple in every Sims game, the Goth Mansion. First impressions, you can tell that they put a lot of work into this one. They definitely spent a little more time on this house than perhaps some of the other ones. It's a little over-windowed, but this is how I would window a house like this anyway. And it wouldn't be a goth house without a cemetery. There's a nice little cemetery here. It's well landscaped. Actually, the whole area kind of is. A little vampire-y with these trees in the front, but I think that's kind of the point of the goths. Inside, they seem to have a conservatory with a chess table. Classic kitchen, love it. I just wish this wasn't a bathroom sink. They use this sink a lot as a kitchen sink. And there's not that many kitchen sinks in the game, but I don't think you should be using a bathroom sink. They're the developers. They could have made more than one kitchen sink. Love seeing a cabinet in the bathroom, like a little like towel stand thing. That's nice. Again, the toilet paper is so far away from the toilet. The dining room, this is stunning. And maybe it's just the way the light is hitting the chairs, but even that is just a piece of art in itself. Love this. I even love this ugly rug with the chairs back here. This is perfect. Love these end tables. This whole thing is great. Sometimes I feel like they design items specifically for the goths or, other big families, and then they just use that stuff and work around all the other Sims. Upstairs is just as nice. See, here you can use the bathroom sink because that makes sense. There's quite a bit of space here for three people. Of course, they're rich. So there's one bedroom here, one bedroom here, one bedroom over here. Bathroom, bathroom, study. Is that a bathroom too? That's a huge bathroom. This is the en suite. Oh my God. Oh, and it's got a separate room for the tub. Why is there a high chair up here? Oh, right. I guess it because Mortimer grew up, so the high chair and the crib are up here. I thought, like, are they keeping babies in the attic? I don't think I can ethically give any EA house a 10 out of 10, but the Goth house, this might be as good as we're gonna get, and I'm gonna rank this one a 9.5. Our next house is called Greener and Greener, and this is owned by another iconic Sims family, the Bachelors. So if you play The Sims 3 long enough in Sunset Valley, you can have Mortimer and Bella get married. Or you can kill her, whatever you want. First impressions, this house is all right. It's just kind of, I don't know, it's just the shape. It's very flat here at the front. I believe Bella's mother is really into gardening. She's like a gardening sim, so that's really nice that she actually has that in her house. Nice little play area for children. Well, I guess for Bella. So I've played in this house before. I remember not loving it, and looking back in compared to the houses we've already seen, I can already see why. Look at this living room. And then look at this bathroom. This living room is the same size, yet we could easily just shrink the bathroom, move the stairs over, and have a bigger living room. Dining room super small too. This is a big house. Kitchen's not even that big, but I do like the easy bake oven in there for Bella. There's the bathroom sink again as the kitchen sink. And why is the computer in the kitchen? Is upstairs any better? Not really. Except I do like Bella's bedroom. She has the skulls on her sheets and she has like a brick wall. It kind of reminds me of Angela Pleasant in The Sims 2. Turning on the lights will make it look a little bit more clear, but here we have the chimney sticking through her playroom, which is kind of dangerous if you think about it, like with like toxic gases and smoke and stuff. This bathroom, ugly, but it looks like a bathroom in real life. That I like about it. But yes, Greener and Greener did not live up to expectations, and we're unfortunately going to have to rank this a 6 out of 10. Next up, we have House Plan B. I don't. I want to like it. Is that the front door or is this the front door? Why would you have two front doors in a small house like this? The roof? Like, what the hell is going on here? Backyard, totally empty. I get it if it's like House Plan B. It's like a basic house that like you're starting off in. So I don't mind a house with some space to expand, but like to have nothing in the backyard, like, oh, I'm sorry. Terrain paint and a tree. Like, what is this, the 10-minute build challenge? And another nitpicky problem is, look at, it's kind of shaped like the letter Y, and you have the two bedrooms furthest away from the bathroom, and that's really inconvenient. There should at least be some sort of ensuite here, or the bathroom should be in the middle. You should have the kitchen over here. I don't know. I don't like the floor plan. I certainly hope that house plans C and D are looking a little better than this one because we're gonna have to give house plan B a 4 out of 10. If you have the creativity to make these nice little pretty things, then why did you make this house, you know? And as I popped out, I noticed that house plan B was 30K. 30K for that nonsense. There's no shortage of iconic Sims here because we're on the land grab house next. Look at this two-door mess. Tudor, not two-door, sorry. I like the roof. The roof was well done. It's a simple shape, but I mean, it's a nice change to not have an ugly roof in this game, to be honest. Love, love, love the hedges here. This just screams rich bitch. I like the fact that it's a brick and not a tile. Let's go inside. I've played in this house too before. I remember it being kind of empty. I'm gonna turn on all lights so we can get a better look and we can see. I think this is one of multiple studies. So you have a study, Oh my God, there's two studies here. There's like a desk for each of them. And then we have our night. Actually, the living room is nice, except I hate the wood color. I don't think that's a very like rich person wood. The white dining tables with the brown wood, unacceptable. Unacceptable. We have creative style that should not be happening. This ugly wallpaper, I love it in the land grab house, but nowhere else. Now, this is a kitchen. We have a double oven. We have, I think, a toaster. No, an espresso machine. Oh, and a coffee machine. When you're rich and working, then you have to be caffeinated. Another brown table with white chairs. Maybe they have some sort of like color blindness that runs in their family. Ugly spare bedroom that probably belonged to Johnny Zest. Ugly bedroom for the nerdy Malcolm kid. They're supposed to be like the rich family. And like when you want to go play in the big rich mansion, you want to feel it. And yeah, we don't feel it with the land grabs. So we're going to give this house a 6 out of 10 for the land grab lot. For our next build, we're going to be at the Lone Wolf Manor, which number one is really hard to find because it's kind of out on its own. This is the first like real modern style that I think we've seen so far. It's kind of hard to say. I don't think The Sims 3 was going for like realistic architecture. What is with this statue? I'm sure at night that little light will lighten it up and make it look all right. This house is owned by Thornton and Morgana Wolf. Of course, the husband has commitment issues. He's a man. So here's the big problem number one. The first floor is literally the gym. Is this a bar outside? Okay, I like having a bar outside. I do like the picnic table, but like, is there a barbecue out here? I don't even see a barbecue. Like, what are you eating outside? Because your kitchen's way the hell upstairs. A wood microwave? Okay, I don't want to get into like science class or anything, but you can't do that. I'm gonna add 1 point to this house because it's the first house we've seen with an actual kitchen sink. You even have the little dish sprayer thing. But in a house this big, wouldn't you have a dishwasher too? Like, where's the dishwasher? Oh, the barbecue is way the hell on the second floor too. So you have the barbecue up here. To be fair, there's a dining seat out here, but for the picnic table and stuff, the kitchen and stuff's all the way up here. The other two chairs are off to the side. I like a little touch like that because in a real house, you wouldn't just have two dining chairs. You'd have a full set, probably, or at least for guests, and then you'd have them kind of off to the side or in a closet or something. It's not a bad layout once you get to the second floor. If you ignore everything I said before, now the house starts to be okay. Other than the wood microwave. And the third floor is even bigger. Oh, wait, no, it's not. It's like lofty. This is kind of creative, actually. I'm glad that it's not full of stuff because then there's not too many places to go. Again, with only two Sims, I don't want to be like digging around the house to see where everybody's at. Another marble bathroom, so I guess they're rich. Why is there two bathrooms in the master bedroom? I understand having like double sinks and like maybe a separate toilet room, but two bathrooms. I don't like where this family's going. I don't want to play this one. Why would you hang the mirror like that? That's so, ugh. See, how hard is that? We could just make it nice. But no, we had to make it ugly. For the Lone Wolf Manor, I mean, it's not my favorite, but it had a lot of good ideas, maybe not the best execution, but I think it's something that's at least playable. I don't like The Sims, but I could handle playing in this house if I had to. I'm gonna give this house a 5 out of 10. I think that's my first five, right down the middle. I was hoping for something epically ugly. I know I've been trying to say these names kind of convincingly, but what the hell is up with these names? Low Fat Ranch? I saw one of the other houses is called Plus Plus. Like, I have no idea what's going on. This looks like every house that I drive by on my way to work. It's also worth noting that Justine Keaton, who lives here, she's pregnant, so we'll keep that in mind when we're looking at the house. Oh my God, she's going to have the baby at the hospital right now. Oh my God. Well, that's fine. That'll give us a chance to kind of dig through her house. I feel like in The Sims 4, it's just random families placed in random houses. They weren't really done together. And I think with these houses, I think they made The Sims and the houses in this game simultaneously. So everything just makes a little more sense. It's a little barren. This looks a little bit like a my first real Sims build. It doesn't have a lot of decoration items. It doesn't have a lot of activity items either. I don't see a computer. I don't see a TV. I don't see anything for fun. But at least the inside is kind of like organized, balanced, and nice. I think it's just kind of average on the inside. But the outside is really nice. And I think I would like to commit to this house being an 8 out of 10. It's nice. It's a nice little, simple, pretty house. Oh, okay, we got the baby. I'm gonna name the baby In My Way because it ruined my little voiceover on the rating. But most people prefer to decorate, and I think this house is great for that because you'd see the outside and be like, oh, awesome, I'm gonna move my Sims in here. And then you get inside and go, ugh, And then you can just go into build mode, get out the sledgehammer tool, and just get rid of things, you know? And last, but certainly not least, actually, maybe least, we have the Metropolitan Lofts. They're next to the Cosmopolitan Lofts that we looked at earlier, and it's got a very similar style. This does look a little bit bigger, and I'm not sure if I prefer this one or the other one, so maybe for this last one, we'll do a little comparison. What I did like about the other lofts is that the layout was very realistic, like roommate-y kind of apartments. This household is called Working Friends, so it's kind of the same idea, where it's people who are not necessarily in a family, but they're cohabitating. Wouldn't really want someone to look over at the computer area. I think looking over at like a kitchen or something would be more appropriate, because a kitchen or a dining room is of like a social space, and like you don't go on the computer with people. That's why I'm here sitting in my room by myself talking to my camera in hopes that somebody will play The Sims with me. Yeah, I don't think that this one is winning me over like the Cosmopolitan Lofts did. At least it's got all funky bump outs and like little balconies. This one is just kind of like a big box. And we're not going to count the pool and stuff back here because this is actually a park. So these are three lots and there's a park behind. So this pool is shared amongst all of them and it's not for this house specifically. The Metropolitan Lofts for me are going to get a 5 out of 10. Not as funky as its neighbor. I don't really like the layout play style as much. I would prefer to have the people a little more separated. And for what landscaping it does have, did a good job. I like this little bush area in the center, but it would have looked a little bit nicer in front of a nicer house, if you know what I mean. Well, I'm over an hour into recording. I didn't realize it would take this long to judge so many houses, but a quick Google search let me know that Sunset Valley has 94 lots in it. So that's about it for this part of the video. For part two, we'll be doing the other half of the occupied lots, and then we'll move on from there. Maybe we'll do another world, or maybe we'll just do the unoccupied lots of Sunset Valley. But anyway, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give me a like or subscribe for some more Sims content. And as always, please let me know in the comment section down below if you have any suggestions or if there's anything that you think I missed. Thanks again. Boom.